It's me, Bussy King, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a lighthearted breakdown of the iconic fight between Kandy Muse and Tamisha Iman in Untucked. The two questions I hope to answer in today's video are, is Kandy Muse manufacturing drama for airtime, and was the whole fight fake? But before I get all anal, itical on you, I just wanna say thank you to Kandy and Tamisha for creating some of the best reality TV drama that we have seen on RuPaul's Drag Race in many seasons. Y'all ladies really, really did that.
I've been around 30 years, little girl.
That's fine. Tonight.
Thank you. I'm also hoping to serve a heaping dose of reality to some of the people that have taken this fight way too far, like these people that have apparently contacted Kandy Muse's mother over this. Y'all need to sit down. Okay, there's never reason to harass someone, period, but especially not over a fight that happened on reality TV.
I'm back to you.
Silence! Bring back my Emmy-winning overproduced reality television showgirls. So Drag Race actually has a pretty rich history of fake drama. And when I say fake drama, I'm referring to anything from the editors adding slurping noises to the girls drinking completely full cocktails in Untucked.
What the fuck?
All the way to completely manufacturing and staging fights like the one between Shangela and Mimi I'm First, the sugar daddy one. And I hate to break that fourth wall for anyone that didn't know that that one was fake, but girl, just look at the lemons on the floor as they cut to the different camera angles. Oh, and that beep at the end of it?
Round up, bitch!
That was added for dramatic effect. She never said the F word. But that's also okay. Like, I love that this show produces moments like that because that is something that Shangela can use for the rest of her career. It's good for her and it's good for the audience. It keeps us interested. What are the drag queens gonna do this episode of Untucked? But what happens when one of the contestants starts playing the role of producer? We're introduced to Kandy as someone who in her confessional says that she needs to prove herself to her now former drag house, Aja and Dahlia Sin. Which is interesting that she sets that challenge for herself because she also tells us that she doesn't jump, sing, dance, or do splits. But guess what? She's loud.
If I was to describe myself in one word, it would be loud.
This pretty much leaves her only one option for proving herself and becoming a memorable queen from the show. Get as much airtime as possible. How do you get as much airtime as possible? You create drama. To fully address the question, I think we need to take a deeper look at the fight that happened in episode 5, The Bag Ball. This episode starts off, the girls are in the workroom debriefing from the previous challenge, and Kandy says, Simone is my biggest competition. Tamisha says, whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't forget about the rest of us. And then in an aside, Tamisha is saying there's a thin line between confidence and, remember this word, arrogance. I think it's really important to note here that is pretty much all that actually happens in terms of discussion between the two girls at this point. But we do also hear two extremely important confessionals here. Tamisha says the pageant has started, so now we can battle. And Kandy says, if she don't shut the fuck up, she's gonna find herself a new enemy. And see, while the actual disagreement between Kandy and Tamisha at this point wasn't that strong, they reinforce it with confessionals that, with clever editing, trick our brains into thinking all of this is really happening at the exact same time, when in reality, these confessionals could have been filmed at the end of that day after that big blow up, or maybe the next day, or I mean, who knows when they filmed those. But the important thing is that they have both given us fight statements. They have primed us. We are ready and anticipating a bomb going off. But that's only half of the story. I'll give you a second to guess where you can find the rest of it.
Girl, if you're not watching Untucked.
So Untucked starts off with Kandy getting every single girl in the room to agree with her. Tamisha should be the one to go home of the bottom three tonight. Why was Kandy saying that Tamisha should have gone home when Lala Ree's outfit was clearly one of the worst outfits in Drag Race history? Could it have been perhaps that she wanted to stoke the flames a bit, get everybody riled up about Tamisha? Then Tamisha comes back with the rest of the girls that were receiving critiques on the main stage and immediately starts saying that she doesn't like some of the girls but respects their drag. Kandy pokes the bear a bit and then gets Tamisha to clarify that Kandy is the one with a nasty attitude and that she thinks she's arrogant. Remember that we heard that word earlier in the beginning of the episode too. Kandy Muse's reaction to Tamisha's call out was disproportionate, I would say. Not uncharacteristic of Kandy, but disproportionate.
Arrogant. Okay, I'm arrogant to you. I'm arrogant to you.
So yeah, I think Kandy faked or manufactured the drama by calling out Tamisha when she wasn't in the room, pushing Tamisha to explain herself, and finally with her overreaction.
If you don't have star quality, baby, get the f out of here.
Girl. But the thing that still doesn't make sense with me is, why did Tamisha say what she said at all? The thing is, we know Kandy wants to create drama to get more airtime, but she can't do it by herself. I hypothesize Tamisha was prompted by production to reignite the flame from earlier and start a fight that they knew Kandy was dying to have. And if you want to get really crazy with me, put on your tinfoil hats. I think there's even a possibility that production could have offered Tamisha immunity from bottom two if she started this fight. I mean, it just was so uncharacteristic of her from what we know about her to do this. So I think it's very possible that really all three parties worked together to manufacture this fight. So who wins and who loses? In the aftermath of this fight, in the real world, we see the show, Kandy, and Tamisha all immediately benefit from this moment. Number one, the show gets people more invested in the characters of their story and ready to find out what happens next. With that, people are picking sides, which helps the girls gain followers and attention. And they also secure media coverage for Untucked. We're in that mid-season lull, and all of these things combined together is the perfect way to keep audiences' attentions at least through the next episode, or maybe until the end of the conflict. But who's losing here? Certainly not the show, in any way, shape, or form. Maybe Kandy? Maybe Tamisha? I mean, they're spending some time dealing with trolls, and Kandy's being very loud on Twitter, as you would expect her to be, about the situation and how she's dealing with it from the perspective of people attacking her. But what's really happening is she's just giving PR to the fight and the show and her brand. Because at the end of the day, all press is good press. And yeah, there are some, I think, ripple effects that nobody could have anticipated, like toxic fans contacting Kandy's mother. But I'd say that's a fairly small price to pay for essentially accomplishing your goal on Drag Race. I think further proof adding to my conspiracy theory is neither of the girls have really talked about this on their social media platform other than from the perspective of dealing with bullies and trolls. I think the show has told them to largely not talk about the fight to keep people invested in the TV show, because I personally believe that we could be seeing this storyline extended, maybe even to a Kandy versus Tamisha lip sync. So in conclusion, is Kandy manufacturing drama for airtime? Yes, very obviously so.
Arrogant. Okay, I'm arrogant to you.
And production is helping her. But like I said earlier, that's not a bad thing. I think Kandy's approach to the show is genius. Inevitably, Kandy will rub some people the wrong way, but I think she's the best antagonist the show has and maybe will ever see, because she also is that relatable underdog and represents a group of people historically underrepresented on the show. I love this tweet from her that she sent out last week. I wish I had a strong, opinionated, outgoing, overconfident, over-the-top, loud, brown, big gay man that does drag on my TV growing up. You sit the f*** down and shut the f*** up. Let me be the representation I wish I had growing up. Let me know what y'all think down in the comments below. Was this an authentic explosion or just another RuPaul's Drag Race overproduction? I also want to remind you that my patrons over on patreon.com/bussyqueen make my channel possible. They get exclusive member benefits like early access to my videos, personal shoutouts, access to the Bussy Queen Discord server, and more. Click the link in the description of this video to join my Patreon family today. I also want to give a special shout out to Stacy, Nelson, VJ, Tristan, Aiden, and Jedi, who have all just joined my Patreon at the tier. And Anthony, Bradley, Cameron, Christopher, Craig, Freddie, DJ Bearcock, Glenn, Got the Morbs, Jenny, Gen X, Jonah, Johnny, Kazuko, Kevin, Kiki and John,
Olympus Mons, Venus,
Ron, Sailor, Shannon, Sky, Sunshine, Tina, and Timothy, who are all supporting me at the hottest tier. And Angel, Caroline, JB, Marty and Cheesy Boy, Matthew, Mike, and Tom, who are all supporting me at the Bussy Queen Collector tier. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next week. Love ya. Bye.